We can use this to now start building response curves. So this was what we had in the last slide, which basically had the log of exposure, pixel values, and these were the three different points, and we were able to trace them out equally in all three of them. Now, assuming unit radians for each pixel, we basically can kind of start making an interesting model here. So what we want to do now is take this and start kind of figuring out how to align them so then they would have a uniform shape. So in essence, what I took, the purple values, and I want to be able to shift the turquoise and the yellow to create a unique profile. And basically what that means is I'm adjusting the radiances to obtain a smooth response curve. So I take all three of them, I basically adjust them around a little bit to create a nice smooth response curve. Once I have this, I have actually gone far in trying to be able to create an inverse G purely from data. Again, remember, G is basically giving me this information. I want to be able to get intensity values and come the other way.